But I'm going to move on here and talk with our next guest. As the nearly $4 trillion ETF market has expanded, Schwab has become one of the top five largest providers. For more, let's bring in Tony Davidow. He's Vice President of Alternative Beta and Asset Allocation Strategy for the Schwab Center for Financial Research. It's a lot to get in there. I want to point out that you are the Schwab Center for Financial Research is an independent organization, and you do research for them. You're not here to talk up Schwab products, we completely understand that. But we'll give you a chance to do that if you want to. Where are we in the state of the ETF business? $4 trillion right now. I know you're very big in smart beta and active management. And yet I look at this and I still see money coming in every year on the bond side and on the stock side, even if you get a few weeks where underperformance. Is this ever going to stop?
I think we're in a great place. I mean, you know, we can kind of look at the size of the ETF business, and clearly the growth trajectory has been incredible, but we also need to keep sight of the fact that it's still relatively small compared to the active management space. I'm not predicting the demise, as I know others have done, but I think there's clearly room for innovation. I'm not sure there's room for a lot of innovation in what I would call the cheap beta, kind of the first generation of indexing, which really just wanted to replicate and mimic the underlying indexes. And I think that's why we're starting to see this really growth and acceleration of smart beta strategies, trying to find out, are there ways we can actually improve the market experience?
Well, you say there's not a lot of room for plain vanilla stuff, yet look what Schwab has done. Look what J.P. Morgan has done. And 2 years ago, Schwab was not a big player.
Yep.
Neither was J.P. Morgan. And now all of a sudden, the last year and a half, because you have Schwab has a very large base of users that are out there, they've gone to that base of users and say, here is a suite of low-cost index products. We're here, stay in the family, and the strategy has worked. 2 years ago, everyone had said, Vanguard's in, BlackRock's in, nobody's going to be able to get into the plain vanilla space. Turns out that wasn't true. J.P. Morgan did the same thing. Huge investable base of people who are already there. Hey, they're getting some traction over there as well.
Yeah,
this is belying the idea you can't make any money on plain vanilla anymore.
Yeah, I mean, asset allocation products are increasingly being used as a replacement for individual stocks in the ETF form, as well as mutual funds. And so the lower cost products, Schwab offers them. You mentioned J.P. Morgan that in 2018 had success in launching products. They launched a new product in 2019 that we think is going to pick up assets tied to U.S. Cost is, unfortunately, the biggest differentiator for investors. They're willing to trade down a basis point or two. I say, unfortunately, because their devil is often in the details. You can get different exposures with the Schwab products than you would other firms.
But, John, don't you think we've reached the bottom on this, you know, 3 basis points or 4 basis points? Schwab's got products that are out there, compete with Vanguard. We look at the international equity product. They have a large cap product, a broad market cap product, small cap product.
Yeah.
Competes perfectly well with Vanguard. It's very similar.
I think a couple bips is a couple bips, right? So, like, let's not get too carried away. I mean, if you're going to sell an ETF, right, for a 1 bip cheaper, you know, you're going to incur taxes, commissions, there could be a taxable gain. So your all-in cost of trading could be orders of magnitude more than just swapping out of a couple basis points.
I think 2018 was the top of the story of let's make a big thing about 2 basis points, because the average retail investor is not going to matter at all. Right, Tony?
Right.
You've noticed that. Now, if you're running a billion-dollar fund, I care if you're 9 basis points and your competitor with the same product is 3 basis points. But if I have $10,000 in the fund, I'm not going to incur capital gains and switch out because of 1 basis.
It's survival of the fittest. I think your setup was perfect. I mean, if you look at where we are today, the beauty is for the individual investor or for an advisor, they have a lot of choices, and they can choose the lowest cost. I don't know that a basis point here or there makes that much of a difference, but boy, they've got a lot more choices today than they've had in the past. And I think that's why, you know, Schwab kind of got into the space relatively late and really has grown pretty handsomely. Good products at cheap prices, that's always a winning formula.
Yeah.